Hello everybody, my name is Quacks. We're having a wicked good day because today we are back with Quackcraft, or whatever this mod pack really is. But yes, we are back with this. So like I mentioned before, you guys have been giving some great suggestions on what else I can record, and I really appreciate it. I haven't really checked most of them out just because I just started this episode and really kind of just got on my computer and thought I'd make this episode for you guys. But what I have been doing is quite interesting. So I made this little upstairs floor, which I don't know if I showed in the last one, but either way, it's a little upstairs floor that we can branch off and make some other buildings. But what I really wanted to get started today was Mine Colony. So this is a really, really interesting mod. Now it's something we're gonna be working with kind of the whole time we play this mod pack, just because they're in need of constant resources. But once you give them what they need, they kind of start creating their own efficient, like, world and society and kind of just mine stuff and, I don't know, just get you a bunch of goodies. Which is really good because it kind of saves me time of having to do certain things. So, without further ado, we should probably get started doing this. Now, what I know from... I hate the weather. So what I know from Mine Colony is that we have to make, I'm pretty sure, this thing, the supply chest first. Now, I don't know why we have to make this thing, but this is apparently what we have to make first. So we are going to grab some logs over here. We are going to, we'll take half of them. I don't think we're gonna need too many. And start making some boats. Now we need, what, 3, 4, 5? We need 5. 1, 2, well, no, right, we can't do that. 2, 3, 4, and 5. So now that's enough boats to create the supply chest. Now the thing about this is, if you guys don't know, you can only have one in the world. Also, you can only have one town hall in the world. So once you like kind of place your, I guess, location of where you want everything, there's only one place that you can put it. So that's like literally it. There's no other way you can change it. The only way I think you can change it is if you like dig everything up and make sure you move it, or you place it relatively close of where you first placed it. I'm not entirely sure, but what I do know is that, yeah, you kind of, it's freaking nighttime already, but you're kind of stuck wherever you place this thing. But apparently this is a massive boat that we're gonna have to place in the ocean. Now that big blue beam right there is where I placed, well, I really found the ocean, I should say. It's where it located is. There's some water over there. I died there. The maze is over there. Home is here. There's a ravine there. What is this one? Right, another death spot. But yeah, I want to sleep before we get on the road. So yeah, I'll see you guys as soon as the sunlight comes up. So I went ahead and made a bunch of stone axes just because there's a lot of wood on this ship and I kind of just want to dig it up. There's no really need that. I think I might keep it, I'm not sure, but I made a bunch of axes just in case of emergency, in case I just, I don't want it. So I'm gonna eat this food, build up my hunger. But yeah, so you'll see it's a really, really, really big ship and you need a lot of space for it in the water at least. So I can't make, I can make a little pond here, like a little, I guess, rectangle pond, but I thought it'd be, oh my God, lagging like crazy. I thought it'd be easier just to, I guess, make it over here and just build a path to it. If I want to ever come back to it, it's nice. It's a really big boat, and plus you could build your home on it. So if you kind of were lost and stranded and have this mod in there, it gives you a pretty quick instant home. So if I right click, I'm pretty sure. Nope, need to be near a big pool of water. That is a big pool of water. All right, we're gonna come over here then. Can I place it now? Yes, yes. Oh, and the chest is right here. Cool. So I get the building tool and a town hall. Now that I can come over here, bum, ba, da, bum, we can climb this sucker and you have now a massive ship. Now I don't really get the point of it. I kind of just think, oh, there's glowstone. I want to take the glowstone. It's really nice. Now I don't have to go to the nether. Okay, I want to put a torch up here just to fix it. But anyways, so now if we look around here, we can see some chests. Now I'm pretty sure they're empty. We have some dispensers here too, in case we ever want to grab those. Yeah, so there are some empty chests. So we got some books here. I'll leave them there for now. I don't think it, actually, no, I'll grab some. Might as well grab some. Oh my God, there's a block of gold. Hell yes. Can I dig it up with a stone? Please, please, please. You dick. All right, so bad thing, do not dig that up with stone. I don't know why I thought that was a good idea, but I wasted a block right there. But either way, so there's gold here. I would never have guessed there was gold right there. Is there another one? No, there's not. Okay, but then there's a downstairs, so we'll check this out. Okay, we're gonna snap through this just because we got some glowstone here. Ooh, there's more books. Holy crap, there's so many books. I'm all fine with taking the books, believe me. But this place has got some little secret treasures. I guess you kind of gotta find them. Of course, that one leads to water. All right, we got a lot of beds here. Don't think there's gonna be much there. Can we dig down? Is there something here? Hello? Nope, just water. Okay, hop that up. Boop, 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 boop. And okay, cool. We're gonna place this back. Just kinda don't wanna really dig up the whole trip. But anyways, let's check this other sale here. Maybe there's something at the top of these crow pits or whatever they're called. Yeah, whatever this thing's called. No, there's literally nothing here, and there's nothing in the other one as well. All right, so we got some glowstone. We have gold blocks there, so that really freaking helps though, because once we get tinkers going, it's kind of nice to have that gold ready so I can start making casts. Which really helps out a bunch. So let's eat this up, get our food going. Cool. All right, so now let's head our way back. Now, the first thing we're gonna wanna make is the town hall. That's kind of where we start generating our people, I guess. So we're gonna throw that sucker in, and then we're gonna make a builder's hut. And what the builder's hut is what's going to allow us to make the town hall. But you have to, I'm pretty sure you have to place the town hall first because the people literally will not spawn in until you have the town hall placed. Ow! Freaking bees. Freaking biting me, pinching my butt. But yeah, so we have to place it over here because I cleared out this whole area just for this town hall. And what's really cool about this mod is that once you have the town hall and you go to place it, break that thing. I don't know what that thing is. Still gotta look up what the freaking thing flying around exploding is. But either way, I kinda wanna place it right in the middle, I think, because it's pretty cool looking. But you place it, and it shows you exactly where it's gonna lay out, which is really cool. But it depends on where you're facing, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, let's dig this sucker up. Please don't break. Please give it back. Cool. So yeah, if you're looking this way, it'll place it differently depending on where you're looking. So this is pretty cool. Oh yeah, see, and then people start spawning just like this. So you'll start getting a bunch of people. I think this is okay, but it does, I'm pretty sure it tells me to place it one block high because it does place weird. So let me dig this up. Let me grab this one block. Okay. Now I'm gonna put it here. Let's look this way. I'm pretty sure I was looking this way. Yeah, okay. So that's not a bad place to put it, I guess. Oh, I forgot, I have the builder's tool. So if I use the builder's tool, go to huts. What? Oh, holy crap. Okay. Decoration huts. We don't have huts. Oh, hold on. If I hold this, will it show me what it looks like? I'm pretty sure it will. Will it show me? Let's see. Let's see. Place it. Right click here. Town hall. Okay, cool. Oh, look at that. Look at that. That's so freaking cool. Oh, okay, so it'll show me the ground like that. Okay, now if we, what do you call it? We right click and we want to move it down one. What was that? Oh, that's moving it towards me. All right, so let's move it back. Is there a way? There's no way to move it down. Okay, so I guess the way to move it down would be to cancel that. So dig this one up and then just click right here. Okay, this is a level one town hall too. So there's better levels and stuff. So this is essentially what it's going to look like. So a lot of wood is going to be put into this, but it's going to be worth it because the town hall really, I guess, like kicks this place off. And it kind of gives me another feature to this game because it gives me, like, I don't know, people. It's nice to have people. I don't know what this guy was just saying, but it was freaking me out. But I'm gonna want to dig this stuff up first because they do it themselves, but it's really tedious and they're really slow doing it. So I'm gonna probably dig that up with my own shovel. So I think this is looking pretty good where it is, kind of like the big town hall right smack dab in the middle. So I think what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna right click this and hit OK. All right. So now what we're gonna need to do is grab ourselves a builder because we have all this new stuff now. It tells me how many people I have, how many builders, delivery men. So there's a lot of stuff. It shows me my actions so I can build the building right now. There's a lot of things, permissions, who's allowed in here, citizens, the settings, and work orders. So once I start getting a builder, I can change who's working on what and who's doing what. So it's really cool. So we kind of want to make the builder's hut now, which is citizen's hut, Builder's hut. Where's builder's hut? Build a builder. Hello, sir. Oh, it's this one right here. Builder's hut. Colony has reached max size. Okay, cool. So we need a door and wood, which is actually awesome because we happen to have a door. Let's collect my berries on this wall here. Just give myself some more food until I start populating these chickens like crazy. I need to make a wheat farm. I got a lot to do, but I might make a couple things off camera just so I don't have to bore you guys. So I'm going to throw some stuff here, throw this over here. Let's switch that one out. All right, cool. So let's grab the door. Where's the door? Holy crap, super unorganized. I could have sworn I had three doors. Nah, are you serious? I don't have another door. What? Would you build a door? I'm pretty sure it gives you three. I could be wrong. Ah, there it is. Ha ha. You're not going to trick me this time. I'm going to need another piece of wood, though. That's definitely what I need. So I'm going to grab those. And put the door right in the middle. And boom, we got our builder's hut. So now, this is where things get really interesting. Because you kind of got to do a little slave labor at the moment. Essentially, what we're going to have to do is give the guy exactly what he's going to want to build with. So if this is being built here, the builder's hut, I don't have an issue with it being kind of right up here on the hill. I'm kind of fine with that. I kind of like seeing it. It's pretty cool seeing. And plus, that's pretty good space. Actually, let's dig this up so I can use the builder's wand. The builder's wand's absolutely beautiful because it shows you exactly where things are going to be, which is really, really cool. So this is what it looks like. It's pretty nifty looking. It's kind of interesting. And let's rotate this sucker. I want it that way. Okay, that's pretty cool. Let's move it back a few toward me a little. All right, that's looking not too shabby. Obviously, there's going to be a step here, but I can make the stairs to fix that. So there's a bunch of things I can do to fix stuff. Sheep, stop it. Thank you. All right, so I have no issue with fixing things. I just don't want it to. Okay, so the tree's right there. Let's move it back one more. I think that should be okay. I don't have an issue with this. This is looking pretty good. So what I want to do now is I'm going to click. That's pretty funny, actually. Oh, no, I wasn't running on it. All right, so let's lock this sucker in. And now what we're going to want to do is see the builder right here. Now, that's the coolest. One of the coolest parts is we have this builder. So when you right click on here, you can recall your builder too. So he'll come here and then he'll tell you what he needs tool wise. And then he'll tell you as well the blocks he needs. But if you come here and click on inventory, you can see what's in here. And then when you hit build building. Yes, build request created. Actually, I'm going to want to cancel that. I kind of want to build my town hall first, I think. Yeah, I think I want to get my town hall built first. I think that's a little more important. So let's cancel this one and let's build this one. I'm definitely going to need to go sleep because there are zombies and stuff, and I really just don't want to deal with them. I'm not sure if monsters can kill the people. Oh my god, that was an Enderman. I'm not sure if they can actually kill the characters. That is something I really just don't know. So if you guys find that out, please tell me because I'm so curious. So let's sleep. Let's get this nighttime gone and hopefully the rain too because I just hate the rain. Cool, the rain went away too. So started building wooden slash town hall 1. Absolutely awesome. So now he's going to go back. You guys can see him running up there. He's going to tell me exactly what he needs, I think. Sir, God, I hate when they do this. They're like completely awkward. Yeah, they do this weird walk around thing. I'm not entirely sure, but if you look over here, it tells you what you need. So 170 wood stairs, 8 cobblestone stairs, 8 dirt, 124 wood, 114 wood planks. Oh my lord, I need a shovel. So he's gonna use a shovel. See, this is where it gets interesting because I need a shovel of max grade of wood or gold. You can't give him anything else. It has to be wood or gold or he will not dig. It is really wonky. I do not understand it. But essentially we need a lot of wood, a lot of oak wood, fences, slabs, and a lot of cobblestone. So essentially kind of gonna go on a little mining mission. I'm pretty sure I have all the wood I'm going to need. I'm just going to grab a bunch of it right now with a crafting table, go over there and see how much I can make But yeah, it's going to be quite intense making this thing because the town hall is like one of the biggest pieces. So when you it requires a lot of resources. So you kind of got to be mentally prepared for this sucker, which is why I kind of pushed it off till just now to do this mine colony thing because there is a lot of prep for it, which is fine because I'm all good with doing it. But I don't want you guys to have to sit here and be bored to all hell watching me do this. So bed there, there. I want to need a wood stair actually. Okay, I don't think I'm gonna need this many axes. I thought I was going to, but I don't think I will. I'm gonna want my shovel. Okay, now let's grab. Oh, we need dirt. Dirt is something we need too. I saw oak plank in here. What else? Fences. It's in here. More fence. Wood, and they'll keep telling you too. He'll keep running back and forth, just constantly telling you what he needs, which is where it gets a little annoying because I don't know if you can stop that, but they're just all around annoying. All right, so the first thing we're gonna need is 124 oak wood. Now that's something I really think we should get first. So this is 120 here. 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's exactly 124, which is absolutely nice. So this here can stay. Then over here, we need 170 wood stairs, 114 oak planks. So this is 64. That's 94. If we get rid of the 7, boop-a-boop, 94. Oh, good God. All right, so we got our wood here. Now we need to make some stairs, which is gonna be a ton. But I think we can get there. I'm pretty sure we can get there. We have enough wood, so we should be okay. I don't see there being an issue. So we got that. We got here. How many do I need? We need 170. Holy good Lord. Yeah, this might be an issue to make the stairs. They might. Yeah, they're gonna be close. It's gonna be close. Make some more. All right, that should be enough stairs. I might be completely wrong, but I don't know. It we're okay so far. So we should just throw some stuff in here just for now, because he won't pick it up until we actually have everything. So well, until he has his shovel. So we have dirt. We need cobblestone. What else can I get? Dirt, spruce door, cobblestone, glass plane, and torch. So I have some torches here. I can give him the 16. 13 fences. How many fences do I have? I have 17. That's fine. I'll throw those in there. Oak wood slab, 94 slabs. Yeah, that wasn't even close. Okay, I need to start farming. I'll be right back, guys. I'm probably gonna do a little speed run so you guys do not have to watch this, but at least you guys can see something going on. Alright guys, so that took literally way too long to do, but either way, we got a bunch of stuff now. So let's come over here and try making some more goodies. What else did we need? We had the stairs. We need cobblestone stairs. We only need 8, which is quite nice because that actually saves me on some stuff. So I'm gonna use these. Boop-a-boop. That's 4, and then we need one more. That gives us 8. So let's throw that in here. Inventory, throw it in there. What else did we need? We'll just go down the list. We had dirt, we have the wood, we have the planks, we have the fence, we do not have the door. We need more slabs. Okay, we'll turn these into slabs. Okay, should be enough. How many slabs do we need? 94. Yeah, that should be enough. Do-do-do-do. All right. What else? I keep doing that. I keep clicking off. Door, slab, cobblestone. We need 110. So that should be around 2 stacks. That should work. Okay, let's look down here. Now we glass plane, torches, and the door. Okay, we can get that. Oh, look, we have spruce. We actually have spruce. How freaking awesome. We can actually make a door. I actually was worried I wasn't gonna have that. Wow, we actually have spruce. Now we have spruce doors. Oh, beautiful. All right, so we should have everything now. It took me a little while to cook up some glass to get the planes. Oh, no, 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 no. The pains, I should not. Planes, pains. We need our coal. We need coal. Coal, 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 coal. There we go. Let's cook up some here. 16, cool. That should be way more than enough. We're going to run over this way. Come on, get back to the place. But yeah, so we should be able to have enough stuff for him. He's going to still want his shovel because I know he's going to want to dig out the area, which is fine and dandy because I'm going to give him a shovel and I'm actually going to help him dig the area because I know exactly what he's going to try to do. So we need 23 torches. So inventory. 23 torches. We got yours, two spruce doors. Go over here, right? And then we have the cobblestone, oak stairs, wood stairs, wood stairs, cobblestone, dirt, wood plank, fence, door, slabs, stone, and 20 panes. So now if we do this, gives us 16, and over here gives us 32, so that should be way more than enough. It's fine if you give him more than he needs because they're just going to use it anyway. So let's give him the shovel that he wants. He's going to run over here and start doing his digging. But kind of don't really want to watch him do that because he's literally going to take 2 years. So I'm going to help him out in just a bit. But while he's doing that, I guess I'm going to go make myself some shovels and start helping him dig out this area. Because you'll see he'll find a spot where he digs, which is usually outside the area he does it, which is really weird. But either way, he'll end up finding a spot where he wants to dig. What's he grabbing? Unless there's nothing to dig. What is he grabbing? Is he grabbing everything? He might be grabbing everything. He might be. I'm not sure. Nope. He's kind of just sitting there. I'm not. I need a shovel. Crap! That's what I did. I gave him a stone. God damn it. So stupid. Alright, so now that we kind of have everything, I'm pretty sure we have everything. I've checked all the goodies. I haven't really seen anything that I don't have. So now he's kind of all set to build this place. So what we gotta get him is his shovel, because he will not stop yelling about that. So what we gotta do is get him that and kind of help him dig out the area. You'll see as he's digging, it's a bit obvious exactly where he's gonna dig up and kind of what he's digging up. So I was gonna help him just because for some reason, no matter, like, even if you give him the gold shovel, it still takes forever. Ever for him to dig stuff up, but for us it would take like super lightning speed, but it still takes a while for him to dig stuff up. So I want to help him out by giving him a bunch of wood. So 1, 2, 3, 4, there we go. We'll give him 4 and I'll keep my stone. I think I'll be okay with one. If not, I'll come back and grab another, but we should be okay. So I'm gonna put these in there, or put them on him actually. I'm gonna right click on him and I should be able to access his inventory and be able to throw one inside. Well, throw them all inside him so he has them endlessly and we don't really have to keep worrying about it. Dude, I know you want your damn shovel. Hold on one damn second, I'm eating some food. All right, bro, so access your inventory. It tells you his strength, endurance, and all that cool stuff as well. So let's throw these inside him. There we go. So he's got all those. You will see over here where he's actually digging. You'll hear the sound as well. So he's going to run this way, I'm pretty sure, and run back that way. I'm not sure where he's going to start, actually. Yeah, here we go. He's digging. Where is he? Oh, here he is. So he's digging right here. So what I'm going to do is, clearly he wants to level this out. So I'm thinking. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to follow his line and just kind of dig it up myself. So I guess a little speed run through right now. So just before I finish this little section here, I want to give you guys a little cool little a pointer. So his digging literally takes that long. So if you guys want to do it yourselves, then I by all means tell, I suggest it just because it gets all of it done quicker. But if you got other things going, just let him do his thing, because he collects what he breaks or like kind of like makes, like over here. See, he's already got all this dirt, so I can take it from him and stuff. So what I'm going to do is, actually, I'm going to cut this one. I will not break the block he's working on just because I don't know if it'll screw things up. So I'll let him do that. There we go. He's going to test through. Okay, he's digging this one. Let's try it. Let's break one. What happened? Okay, he's digging out more. Okay, cool. So I'm going to keep looking and just making sure he's not going to dig anything else up. Where else are you doing it, bro? What is happening? Is he placing cobblestone somewhere? I think he's placing cobblestone. I don't know what he's doing. I hear like the sound of cobblestone breaking, but I'm not entirely sure. Okay, this is a bit odd. Alright guys, so I really have zero clue what the builder did here, but he kind of made this really weird digging hole things. I have no freaking clue. Like, what is he doing? I have zero clue what he's doing, but he made all this pattern in the ground. I'm pretty sure he's gonna go get the stuff now to build it, but I don't know what the pattern is. I literally have never seen this, and I did a little test run too, just so I knew how to do the mod, but like, what the frick is that? Hopefully he explains what he's doing here. Sir, don't push me. Explain yourself. Okay, he's got stone. Oh, he's filling it with cobblestone. Okay. Oh, and with what was the whole point of digging it up, you moron? Wow, he's literally an idiot. Oh, he's gonna ask for more dirt. He's gonna ask for more dirt. Are you kidding? Okay, that's crap. You're crap, sir. You literally are full of crap. I don't understand anything you just did there. I guess it's like it just read it wrong. I guess it was reading it as a different block and just dug it up to place it itself anyways. I really have no clue. But it's really worth seeing this thing get built because it's really cool how he does it. Well, how it's done, I should say. So once he builds that, he's going to go all the way back now to grab the rest. So what should I do? I don't have enough inventory space. I was going to grab it all and like snap them on him. But that's something you can do as well. Put all the items on him, and then he can build it that way. It's probably a lot faster. But I'm not sure what he's doing next. He isn't asking for stuff, which is good. That means we actually put a bunch of stuff in there so he can use. Okay, what are you doing now, bro? Okay, we're doing the next layer. Was that it? Was that seriously it? You placed one cobblestone? So this is where it gets kind of tedious. Like, if you're actually watching and waiting for this guy to do his thing, it's literally going to take forever. So you got to be careful. Like, if you're doing your own thing out there while he does this, then awesome. You're literally going to save time. But I'm doing this just to kind of show you guys how this works. But after this one, I'll do the builder's hut on, like, in my own spare time. I'll let him build his thing. Let him do what he's got to do, because it's always odd how he goes to his own corner. Like, there's a specific spot that he'll actually go to, and then he'll travel back. I don't understand why, but it's just how he works, I guess. So I don't question it. I let him do his own little boring thing here. Anyway, so he's already got the steps going on. This is why I kind of wanted to hear, because the builder's wand did show us exactly where this was going to be placed, which is really cool. They suggest building it one high, just so he doesn't run into that issue of building it like he was doing. Ooh, look at this go, look at this go. Oh, it's looking so good. Oh, it's looking awesome right now, though. He's got to go grab more stacks, I'm assuming. Like, more cobblestone and probably some more wood. I think he has a stack of wood, so he should be okay. It's the cobblestone he's probably going to go grab. But it's coming together. It's looking pretty cool. I kind of wanted to show you guys what it looks like towards the end. I don't really want to make this like a super long episode of just watching him build. So I will be right back with you guys as soon as he's closer to getting the sucker done. Alright, so here it is completely built. I know there was a part in there that I had to skip. It's because I went over there, grabbed all the resources, and threw it on him so we could build the last bit of that really fast. But this is essentially what the town hall looks like. So I built it on the plane, like where it's just right here on the ground. And it looks pretty dang snazzy, and I can always make a path leading to the other places and stuff. So there's a lot of things we can do with this, which is really cool. And plus, once I get this little society kind of set up, it leads to me being able to get resources without having to actually get them. All I gotta supply is the tools, which is really cool. Now, I don't know everything about this mod, so do not take my word for everything, but this is pretty cool. So we start off with this, create the builder's hut and stuff, but it's cool. It's cool. Look, they even put the torches around, so it's well lit. But if you come over to the table again, you can still access everything all over again. So that's essentially what I wanted to show you for Mine Colony. Now, this is a really cool mod. I really like it. It's in my mod pack just because it's, I don't know, it's cool. You can have a little society, have your people, there's workers, there's other ones exploring somewhere. God knows where they went. But yeah, so this is the next one we gotta create, is the builder's hut. But we're not gonna do it on video. I'm gonna probably do it off cam so you guys don't have to watch the whole thing. If you guys wanna see more of this built, more buildings, because we have a bunch more to do. There is the citizen's hut, the mine, the sawmill. This gets resources, this gets resources, the bakery gives food. Delivery man, a forge, quarry. There's so much to do. Quarry might be really good to get. I gotta look up some certain things, but fisherman hut, there's so many things we could do. And you can even make like walls and stuff, guard towers, warehouses, so many things we can do, guys. And it's really cool to have this going. So if you guys want to see any more builds with Mine Colony, definitely tell me, because I'm gonna have them built on my own time. But if you guys want to see them more built on camera, tell me. Any other mods you guys want to see like sooner than later, then tell me as well. I'll probably hop one of those next. But yeah, so this is coming together. I'm still on the hunt for this flint chicken. I haven't found him yet, but there's definitely a mission to find him just so I can start getting some, iron chickens and not really have to worry too much about having to find iron and stuff, which I have enough. I have enough stuff, but you know, it's always good to just start farming resources without having to do it through magical crops just yet, because that's kind of OP right there. But either way, if you guys enjoyed this, please hit that like button, subscribe if you have not already, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Thank you so much for watching, and yeah, tell your friends, family, and everyone about this channel and videos, and yeah, see you.